And welcome to video 12 in our series, Minimum QuickBooks, Owner's Withdrawals. This means recording payments from business bank accounts for non-business reasons. There are only three possible reasons for any reduction of a bank account. Either you're transferring to another business bank account, or you're paying a normal business expense, and these are things we learned in previous videos. But in this video, we will learn how to record withdrawal of money to the owner from the business. This means the money comes from the business bank account for non-business reasons. Any transaction where you're paying from a business account and the money goes to the owner or to something that only the owner needs that's not related to business, that type of transaction constitutes withdrawals. So any transaction that fits that description will be recorded in the account called withdrawals. And if you remember, we already have a withdrawals account in our chart of accounts. For example, let's imagine on July 12, Holden wrote check number 1 for $100 from his T&M business account payable to his wife for stealing money from her pocketbook. This is completely unrelated to business, and he's actually paying her back from the money he stole in a previous video. So, how would we record this? The transaction did say that the money came from the T&M bank account. So let's open the T&M register. Now, click the calendar box, scroll to July of 2016 and choose July 12. Click in the number field, and regardless of what QuickBooks suggests, change it to the actual check number of the transaction. In this case, it's check number 1. Now, Holden's wife, Renee, is not on the vendor list, but you can add a vendor at the moment that you're making a transaction. Just click Add New and make sure that you're adding a vendor when it says Select Name Type. When you click OK, a window that we used in a previous video will open up. We already have seen this window, the new vendor window. All you have to do is type in the first name of Holden's wife and then click OK. And you'll notice her name has been added to the list of payees, so we know whom the money went to. Now, regarding which account is related to this transaction, this money is coming out of a bank account for non-business, so the account is Holden's withdrawals. And because the bank account is decreasing, make sure you put in $100 in the payment field. Can you predict what the results will be after you click record? That's correct. The balance will go down to $1,480, and Holden's withdrawals will show up for the first time as $100 in the trial balance. We click record, and now we can close any kind of advertisement that pops up. In fact, click the Don't Bother Me box, then click OK. Now, if we open the trial balance, you can see Holden's withdrawals has shown up for the first time as $100, and the balance of T&M Bank went down to $1,480. Let's try one more real-world example. Let's imagine on July 13, Holden withdrew $50 from the ATM machine taken from his Chase business bank account. He spent the cash on his child's pharmaceutical. That means this ATM withdrawal from Chase Bank is not for business and therefore should be withdrawals. You can close out these, and we can open up the Chase register, and we can put the date July 13. In the number field, remove whatever's there and put the actual ATM withdrawal slip 11223341. 11223341. Now, in this case, we probably should leave the payee blank. You could always add Holden's name the way you added Renee's name, but the account definitely is Holden's withdrawals. And this is definitely a payment because it has decreased the Chase bank account. Can you predict what the results will be when you click record? That's correct. The balance of Chase will go down to $1,600 and $50 will increase Holden's withdrawals, and Holden's withdrawals will increase to a total of $150 here in the trial balance. We click record, we open the trial balance, and we notice Chase Bank is down to $1,600 and Holden's withdrawals has increased to $150.